morning and welcome to 3 minutes on Markets and Money. I'm your host, Lance Roberts. Yes, we're back. And of course, that means 3 minutes on Markets and Money are back as well. And let's catch up. After a couple of weeks of being out for my surgery, not a lot happened. I mean, if you just take a look, when I left to go out for surgery, the markets are basically are higher than they were then. And pretty much doesn't really seem like much has changed. But there actually has been some changes. No fiscal stimulus, no real support coming for the economy. Corporate profits, 23% lower on a year-over-year basis. Really concerned about the next presidential election, what the outcome is going to be, and if we even get one on time. But apparently nobody cares when it comes to the financial markets. Markets have been running up very nicely. Right before I left, we talked about the fact that the markets had issued out a money flow sell signal. And that was right here at the peak of the market back in September. And we warned then about the correction potential of that sell signal of the markets. And then, of course, just before I left, we talked about the fact that we had now registered a money flow buy signal. And then during that period of time, markets have rebounded nicely up to this point. And we're now back towards all-time highs. Now, here's the important thing to pay attention to. Now the issue is that the money flow buy signal is now back towards its all-time highs, as well as our MACD signal is back to more extended levels on a short-term basis. Doesn't mean that the market's about to crash here, but do pay attention, because the money flow buy signal is beginning to narrow here, and that suggests that over the course of the next 3 to 4 weeks, we could see that money flow buy signal turn lower, and that could help bring prices back in line with the market again. As we approach all-time highs, there is a good level of resistance here, but it would not be surprising here at all if we do break out to all-time highs. The other side of this is also to look at bonds, because the 10-year Treasury and the 30-year Treasury have now started to find some support here. And we've talked about this for a while. Rates did tick up here over the last couple of weeks while I was gone, as the stock market was rallying here. But bonds have been finding really good support along their 200-day moving average. This suggests that we may start to see another rundown in rates after this recent tick up. And that could actually provide a bid for bonds in the short term for the market as well. So if we do see weakness in the stock market over the course of the couple of weeks ahead, I would expect to see a rotation from stocks back into bonds at that point. Also, keep paying attention to the U.S. dollar. The dollar continues to base along this long support line, getting very oversold here on a money flow sell signal. And again, a stronger dollar here would also be a function of falling interest rates as money flow comes into the U.S. from foreign reserves. And that would also probably correspond with a weaker stock market and a weaker commodity market. I'm your host, Lance Roberts, for 3 minutes on Markets and Money. We'll see you tomorrow.